an extremely crazy ride for you guys since the release of your debut. How are you doing? You know, how is everything holding up now? How have things changed?
Oh man, that's a great question. Well, we spent this year making a record, and you know, I think we weren't sure when we first started out. I had no idea how much work it was going to end up being, and a lot of like when we made our first record, we just were a local band and we made it at our friend's, you know, living room or whatever. This record, we had more time and more resources, and so spending the year making the record, we kind of knew the whole world. You know, we knew everyone was going to hear it, you know. We sort of knew, like, some people are really rooting for us, and, you know, some people are kind of standing their arms crossed and they kind of don't buy it or whatever. But one way or the other, it's like, this is like, we saw it as like, okay, you got a chance to stand in front of the whole world and say something. So it's like, okay, well, what do you want to say?
Oh, wow,
and I think All At Once was our answer to that question.
Very awesome. Yeah, I mean, it is an incredible album. And, you know, with all that success and, you know, in just a few short years, you go from this local band to, you know, Morrissey praising you and, you know, Adam Clayton saying that Sometime Around Midnight is one of the greatest songs you've ever heard. How proud are you on your success? Looking back on everything, you know, how do you get chills thinking about it? Like, fuck, like, this is me. Like, I'm here at this time. Like, this happened to me.
Sometimes, I guess, but most of the time, not really. Most of the time, I'm just sort of thinking about other stuff, and I don't really feel like we've done that much as a band, like, from a historical perspective. We had one record, and then we toured a lot, and I think I'm mostly proud of it. We were at South by Southwest, going around watching all these bands, and I was like, oh, these guys are doing that thing, and these guys are doing that thing, and I just thought, like, I don't want to be in a rock band. Like, I want to be in the Airborne Toxic band. Like, I remember really, like, I really thought about, like, kind of the culture we've established at our shows and the kind of connection we have with our fans. And, you know, this is the way I want to go about music. Because we're not really a rock band. You know, maybe, like, Noah is a rock dude and Darren, I guess, to some extent. But I'm not really, like, a rock and roll singer in, like, the way that you would probably, like, say, like, you know, like, you know, Lou Reed was, or David Bowie or something. Like, I'm just like a writer fronting a band, and we're just writing songs about stuff around us, and it's not really kind of like the classic rock, you know, approach. You know,
right.
I just don't have, like, good enough hair or something. You know, it's a whole other sort of thing, and what it's sort of more based on for us is, it's about communication, I think, and I really like that about our band. You know, that's the thing I'm probably most proud of, is that, you know, we never really got much by way of breaks. You know, we never got a big tour opening for anyone. We never really got much press. We just kind of, like, went around, and we just sort of toured and played. And like, the first time we go to a city, 100 people would come, and then the next time 200 would come, because each one of those 100 would come back and bring a friend. And it feels like, you know, these people, we have a sort of connection with them. And it's a really enviable position to be in. If there's one thing about the band that I'm most proud of, it's just the work we've done on the road and really connecting to audiences, like, you know, in all these different places.
Yeah, no, and it definitely shows. I mean, it's just been great seeing you, like, through the years, every time I crack open the Village Voice, knowing you guys are coming around. You know, it's, again, like, a bigger venue, and, again, it all kind of is a microcosm on this new tour that you're going to be doing, which is going to be very cool. Now, with this and, you know, being on the road for so long and then, you know, recording and making this your career and your life now, is it still exciting for you?
Oh, absolutely. No, it definitely is. It's extremely exciting. It's like the focus of my whole life right now. And it's like, we're very, very fortunate to be able to be in a position. I feel really fortunate to have such great bandmates. Like, they're all really, really good musicians. Like, I can't, like, I play cowboy chords, what are called cowboy chords. And I even use a capo, not because I like the way it sounds so much as I'm just not a very good guitar player, you know. And, like, all my bandmates are, like, amazing musicians. They're, like, so fucking talented and so good at their instrument. And, you know, I'm just kind of like this writer writing songs. And I feel very fortunate to have them. I feel we're a very sort of unlikely story. Like, nobody really kind of believed in us at the start. And we've just kind of, like all along the way, I feel like we've had to, like, go and just kind of build the thing ourselves. Like, you know, like, I look at all these bands and people get so excited, and I'm just, about these new bands, and I just think to myself, like, that was just like how this other band was 2 years ago, and then there was 2 years before that, there was this other thing, and they kind of come and go. And, like, you know, I think the bands that stick around, or the musicians that stick around, are the ones that they really get that, like, you know, it's like writing is about loneliness, you know, it's about, you know, you write something because you're so overwhelmed by it that you can't, you can't just keep it in your head, you have to kind of like put it out into the world, and because you want it. Something about communicating it makes it seem, I don't know, less overwhelming.
Mm-hmm.
And then, like, on the other side of it, as a listener, there's like a moment where you recognize, or a reader, if it's like a book or something, like, because these are all just forms of storytelling, like, that, like, you know, you recognize something of yourself in a song or in a book or something, and you think, like, oh, I felt that way. I felt, there's that moment where you're just like, oh my God, other people have felt the way I felt. And there's something about that that's, like, really just comforting and really good. And, like, I feel that way about everyone from Bruce Springsteen to the Arcade Fire to, you know, the ones that I'm, like, the artists that I really admire, Otis Redding to, you know, CeeLo. There's something about each one of these people that it's not about aesthetics, and it's not about genre, and it's not about how they look, and it's, and these are all things that are kind of accoutrements to what's at the core of it. What it's about is communicating through a song.